Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand for the Pacific Northwest University of Health Sciences ceremonial mace carried by Dr. Emily A. Strike, chair of the, chair of the Comm Faculty Council. The arrival of the mace marks the official opening of this commencement ceremony for the Pacific Northwest University of Health Sciences College of Osteopathic Medicine. We ask that you remain standing for the procession of the platform party and the presentation of colors.
Thank you. Thank you. Please be seated. I stand before the future of osteopathic medicine. Embrace it, enhance it, protect it. As osteopathic physicians, you'll bring an invaluable and distinctive perspective to medicine as it's practiced in the United States and increasingly as it's practiced around the globe. Healthcare is enhanced by osteopathic medicine, and we are so proud to have you represent our school. Now it is both a privilege and an honor to introduce to you the Provost of Pacific Northwest University of Health Sciences, Dr. Edward Bilski.
Good afternoon. As Provost of Pacific Northwest University of Health Sciences, and on behalf of the Board of Trustees, faculty, and staff, I am delighted to welcome you to this most significant occasion. I'd like to recognize some distinguished guests who are with us this afternoon. I'm going to ask that they stand as I introduce them and remain standing until everyone is introduced. And audience, please hold your applause until we are finished introducing everybody. I'm pleased to recognize representative members of our current Board of Trustees from Pacific Northwest University of Health Sciences. This includes Dr. Heather Phipps, who is our board chair, Dr. Christopher Clark, Dr. Jim Haven, Dr. Larry Larson, Dr. Vaughn Bullfinch, Dr. Bruce Kinney, and Dr. Vicky Ibarra. Along with them are other Board of Trustee members, Priscilla Cadwell, Dennis Fulton, Karen Hyatt, Kevin Van Nordwick, and John Bornbrock. Other members of the platform party include Dr. Michael Lahr, our president, Dr. Emily Astrike, chair of the Faculty Senate, and members of the Comm leadership team, including Drs. Mark Cody, Stephen Laird, Elizabeth McMurtry, Anita Scholwalter, and Robert Soros. We also have the department chairs up on the platform party, Drs. Mark Baldwin, Misha Coleman, Bill Elliott, John Moore, and Diana Rhodes. And we have our honorary hooders, including Drs. Astrike, Dr. Al Brady, Bill Elliott, Mark Cody, Diana Rhodes, and Professor Aaron Heppner, along with the Dean of the College of Osteopathic Medicine, Dr. Tom Scandalis. I'd like to also recognize Dr. Andrew Sund from Heritage University, his wife Norma. Thank you for being here, and any of our other partners through Heritage, Washington State University, and Central Washington University. Partnerships are very important to us here at PNWU. The members of our state legislature have been instrumental in our founding and continue to support us in many, many different ways. They include Senators Curtis King and Jim Honeyford, and Representative Bruce Chandler, Jeremy DeVault, and Chris Corey, along with Gina Mossbrucker. Many legislators across Washington and Pacific Northwest also stand in support of PNWU. And we're also deeply indebted to Senators Murray and Cantwell and Representative Dan Newhouse for all of their support. So please be seated. And now I'm honored to invite Dr. Heather Phipps, the chairman of the Board of Trustees, to the podium She's going to be followed by Dr. Keith Peterson, president of the PNWU Alumni Association. They're going to extend greetings to the graduates, and Dr. Lau will follow Dr. Peterson to announce the recipients of the presidential citations.
Thank you, Dr. Bilski. Honored graduates, family, friends, faculty, and administration, I am pleased to be here with you today at Pacific Northwest University of Health Sciences' 8th annual commencement. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I want to extend a heartfelt congratulations to all of our graduates. You have dedicated the last 4 years of your life to the hard work and long hours that are required to learn the art and science of becoming a physician. You have spent time away from your family, friends, and other opportunities in the pursuit of learning and knowledge. As of today, you have achieved a major life accomplishment, and you have earned the right to be called doctor and to sign DO after your name. Graduation from medical school is a tremendous success, and the Board of Trustees, the administration, the faculty, your friends, and your family are proud of your accomplishment. Take a moment and relish your triumph and enjoy where you are in your life at this moment, right now. While I am here to extend congratulations on behalf of the board, as a fellow physician, I cannot help but leave the graduating class with a few words. Keep your family and friends close and prioritize time with them. They are your support system. As physicians, we don't need to try to deal with tragedy alone or try to be superheroes. Let your relationships be part of your resilience. Treat others as you would want to be treated, not just your patients. Remember to care for and support your colleagues as well. Remember that you're human, and that's okay. As osteopathic physicians, we are healers who take into account all aspects of a patient's life and are kind and compassionate towards those who are afraid, who are in pain, and who are ill. Never stop asking questions and learning. Enjoy yourself and your art. And again, the PNWU Board of Trustees congratulates the class of 2019.
It's been nearly 9 years since I lived in Yakima, and 7 years since I walked across this stage. You all have accomplished so much and have so much to be proud of. Medical school is no joke. The labs, the Dr. Elliott Kahn tests, general surgery rotation to internal medicine wards, worrying about what rotation's coming next, and going through all the steps. You made it. Showing your professors, preceptors, and deans that you have what it takes to be part of our time-honored profession. You have in your hands the ability to make people well. As you move on to your next journey, realize that you're never alone. Look around you. You're the eighth class. We are building a wealth of experience, and there is rarely, if ever, an original problem. Reach out to the Alumni Association if you find that you are having a problem or that you need advice. If we don't have the exact answer, we likely have more time than you do, and we can help you find it. If you need help finding a job, we can help you with that. Networking with other alumni for friendly consultation, we can help you with that. Please keep in touch with the Alumni Department, who produce an alumni newsletter. Please let us rejoice with you with rejoiceful moments such as wedding announcements, child announcements, or other rejoiceful moments such as significant publications. Also, let us mourn with you in times of loss and grief. The university will also communicate with us about faculty and university staff through this publication as well. After all that, graduates, I'm honored to welcome you to the family of osteopathic physicians and to the PNWU Alumni Association. The Alumni Association is made up exclusively of people just like you and me, who have walked the very same paths that you were on, and who actually will be living in towns and cities that you're moving to soon. Congratulations, and welcome.
Good afternoon. I'm going to talk about some special people here. So thank you, Dr. Phipps and Dr. Peterson. This afternoon is special in so many ways. In 2012, we graduated our first class and also began the process of honoring those who have done so much to make PNWU a reality with the awarding of presidential citations. Some of the past recipients are here with us today and on stage with us. The citation includes the President's Medal, awarded to a member of the university community in recognition of extraordinary and unique service and contributions to PNWU. Today, we welcome three additional individuals to this circle. And in this honoring, I would ask that Dr. Phipps join me as we congratulate these recipients. These are extraordinary people. We love all of them. They are key to the success of PNWU. Many of them have done their work in the background, as some of us have been in the front. Greatly appreciated leaders. I would ask Virginia Hislop to join us on stage. The first citation honors Virginia Hislop for her decades of dedicated service in education. Ms. Hislop will be 100 years old in a few weeks. She may be 100 years old, but her wit is remarkable, and her wisdom and humanity greatly appreciated. So, Ms. Hislop, the Board of Trustees have authorized me to award this presidential citation to you for your dedicated service to education on this 18th day of May, 2019. Congratulations. The next citation recognizes Ms. Patricia Wade Temple for her lifelong philanthropy and service to community. Ms. Temple, if you could join us. Ms. Temple is a key supporter of PNWU. Without her, we wouldn't be here today. She's a great citizen of the Yakima community, modeling outstanding service, philanthropy, and leadership. And a little known fact, at the College of William & Mary, she played on the varsity field hockey team. So just to be clear. So. Thank you, ma'am. So for, please. Yeah. So, for extraordinary commitment to quality medical education and service to the mission of PNWU, the Board of Trustees has authorized the presentation of this presidential citation to you on May 18, 2019. Thank you, ma'am. Appreciate it. Yeah. And finally, we recognize Dr. Robert Sutton for his distinguished service to the health of rural communities across the country, and most notably here in Yakima at PNWU. Dr. Sutton, Please join us on the stage. Dr. Sutton has educated generations of healthcare professionals who are contributing to the health and well-being of countless individuals and communities in this region. Thank you, Dr. Sutton. For extraordinary commitment to quality medical education and service to the mission of PNWU, the Board of Trustees has authorized the presentation of this presidential citation to you on May 18th, 2019. Congratulations.
Now, as always, I'm going to break script. There's just a couple things I want to say, and I'll have to say that I'm astounded to be the midget in the giant among the giants that have supported the school. Ginger, as we talked about, is Yakima royalty. She came to Yakima when I was 4 years old in Wenatchee. I'm a graphic representation of how long she's been here supporting. FDR was president, the war was coming to an end, and for her to carve out a small part of her heart for PNWU is amazing, exciting, and it really shows the acceptance of PNWU to somebody who has supported the kinds of things that we stand for. So I want to recognize that. I want to recognize Pat Temple, the whole Temple family, and Brig. Again, Yakima royalty, and with her family, we wouldn't be here. The ground that the school is on, every day. I remember in the first year, she had one of our students living with her, and it's that kind of ongoing support all the way through. Amazing supporter of PNWU, was on the board, somebody that I've gotten to know personally, have a great deal of respect for people who give up their time, give up their money, give up their influence. Are just a part of our fabric. So I am really honored to be a part of that. And the one thing I want to say is that I would like to accept the citation on behalf of all the faculty and staff, as a representative of all the faculty and staff who have worked for 12 and a half years on this school. And those that are from the school will recognize this piece. But you know, we've recognized all the people that have helped us get here. They built us the shell. We're kind of the dirt walls. And you can talk to some of the people afterwards, but we put the fabric together inside of this, and it's the faculty and staff that have done that. And so I want the others that have come before to know that we have done something with what you have given us, and we appreciate that support. And for those of you of the class of 2019 and your parents and friends, This is what enabled that to happen. Just tireless work from the community and tireless work from a group of faculty and staff. So, thank you.
I'd like to take a moment to recognize individuals who received awards at yesterday's awards luncheon. Congratulations to Paula Archer. She is the recipient of the Dr. and Mrs. Fred Tenning Osteopathic Principles and Practice Award in honor of our past faculty member and department chair, Dr. Millicene T. Tamper. This award recognizes students who have excelled in OPP and who are committed to applying osteopathic skills into their primary care practices throughout their careers. Congratulations, Paul. On behalf of the American Osteopathic Foundation and the Auxiliary of the American Osteopathic Association,
notes from residents and attendees that likely never, ever read them. And of course, my personal favorite, placing many, many family members. Throughout the day to day, week to week, and even year to year, we've been slowly chipping away at these borders so that we can be here today and go forth into residency to further pursue the answers to this question of why this. You guys, we have so much to be proud of. As Dr. Jared Wynn said during our White House ceremony on this stage a lifetime ago, we drank the water to the fire hose and we didn't drown, even if we aspirated. Thank you, Dr. Peterson. It's now my honor to introduce our keynote speaker. Each year at the graduation, we strive to develop our keynote and commit to our mission and our purpose. Inspire the audience, and the humor, and keep on the street time to our needs. Dr. Scandell is a big thank you for your time. This year's selection is natural. Very gracious and wants, and you feel very safe in my job, so as provost and chief academic officer of the university. I want the recommendation of the faculty and dean of the college roster members. I recommend these candidates to you to grant Dr. Boston Mathematics. The state of Washington authority vested in the Pacific Northwest University of Health Sciences Board of Trustees. I hereby confer upon him the degree Dr. Boston Mathematics.
Dr. Euro and Nash, internal medicine, Parkview Medical Center, Pueblo, Colorado. Dr. Katie Justice, pediatrics, University of Illinois, Peoria, Illinois.
Dr. AJ Leahy, emergency medicine, Southeastern Cleveland, North Carolina.
Thank you.
beneficial.